Hello, this is Dr. Christy Patton-Lukes, a chemical engineering professor at Missouri S&T. We are continuing our study of finding roots of equations by various numerical computation techniques, and in this lesson, we will begin looking at the secant method. Now, specifically, we are looking at solving a cubic polynomial equation that's generated by the Peng-Robinson equation of state for chlorine. This method that we're looking at now, the secant method, is a modification of the Newton-Raphson technique. What we're going to do is we're going to approximate the derivative. So instead of saying that we're going to take our previous guess of x minus the function evaluated at x over the derivative of x, we're going to approximate the derivative by taking f of x at our last guess minus f of x at our previous guess, divided by the last guess minus the previous guess. So we're going to need two starting values for this. So this is going to be a problem, but the advantage is I just need a description of my function. I don't have to calculate the formula for the derivative. We're going to stop pretty much the same way we've been doing, using relative error. We're going to say that x new minus x old divided by x new needs to be less than our epsilon value, our tolerance. The programming logic is fairly straightforward. We're going to start by guessing two first values and set a maximum number of iterations, and then we'll initiate our loop at I equal to 1. We'll evaluate the function at x0 and x1, those first two values. And then we'll calculate the new value of x using this formula. From that, we're going to then need to estimate delta. And if delta is within tolerances, then we are going to have to make a choice. Either yes, we're within tolerances, in which case we're finished, or we need to repeat the loop, in which case we're going to set x, the most recent x, we're going to shift the subscripting on this. Now x1 will become x0, x new will become x1. And then we're going to evaluate the function at the point that we need to. We'll increase our increment and we'll continue the loop. I am not going to take us into Excel or VBA on this one because I think it's pretty straightforward. You should be able to adapt the code that we've used before. So from our bisection routine, from the Newton-Raphson routine, you're going to need to read and write values to the appropriate places in the spreadsheet. Now remember, we're going to be having to bring in two new values. So that is more like the bisection method. We're going to use this new formula to calculate x new. And it may be helpful to you to do a new function that does the my derivative, or you can do it in multiple steps as outlined in the flow sheet. So what I'm going to recommend is that you take one of your old codes, copy it, give it a new name, then start making your modifications, okay? Make sure that you've saved it, save it periodically, and then try running it. You should be very successful with this. In our next lesson, we're going to be moving to a sort of different technique. It's called successive substitution. So thank you very much for your time.